also at the same time, you're also at a point where not only you're correcting the value, you're correcting the color at the same time. Okay, so again, visually, if you can't see it, just hold a piece of paper, take a look, okay? And you could say, okay, definitely needs to go darker, and I think it definitely needs to go a little cooler. Mm-hmm. Okay, so now I'm going to adjust my mixture, okay? It definitely looks a little more violet. Now, you can also, that test swatch, you could test this on your test swatch to see exactly what you're getting, okay? But really, at some point, you got to get to a point where you can just say, okay, I know exactly what's going to happen when I take this color and this value and put it over this. Also going to go over the shadow. So we're kind of repeating that last step when we work on the flesh.
And this is just a local color with a little more warm added.
Well, I cooled it down a bit.
Oh, you cool.
So he could match the photo.
Okay, see, now when I come to this edge, I'm actually going to see what I'm doing with my shadow? I'm taking it right into the background. Okay, because it's going to start to soften that edge at the same time to the back. To treat all the larger areas first. Then we're going to come back with some more pure color. You know, I did that the last time, and I didn't like it. Thank you. continue in that fashion for a little bit. Now, here's one of the most important things. We're going to go into the flesh. You're going to find the darkest piece of flesh. And usually when you have this type of lighting, it's going to be right here. Okay? 90% of the time. Okay? Here, it's almost as dark there, but usually it's over in this corner when you have this typical Rembrandt lighting. So, I'm going to go back into my shadow. It's basically what I want to do is, in the flesh overall, okay, right now in the whole thing, we have our darkest established, which is the pupil. But in the flesh, in terms of bringing up the flesh tones, we want to also establish the darkest shadow, all right, which is right there. Because if you have your lightest light and your darkest dark, you're going to find it much easier to judge these values in between.